So I don't know if you've seen this AutoHotKey script yet. I probably used it earlier. This is one of the ones that I'm particularly proud of. It's my Instant VFX Hot Text Selector mod. Basically, what it does is inside the Effect Controls panel, it will find any given variable's hot text and then move the cursor there, click and hold the left mouse button virtually so that I can just move the mouse around in order to change that hot text without me having to physically move the mouse all the way over there manually. And then when I let go of the key, it moves the cursor back to where it was to begin with. So I'm just going to go through this script with you real quick here so that you understand how it works in case you want to modify it for your own setup, which you have to do. I mean, this won't work out of the box. It's called Instant VFX. It's got one parameter, but first, the VFX key global variable must be defined so that it knows what to look for during the function. At the very beginning, we block the input of the mouse and keyboard so that it doesn't interfere with anything. Then we define a few variables. We save the x and y coordinates of the cursor. And then it gets the position of Drover Lord Window Class 3, which is the unique identifier for what I know the Effect Controls panel is on my own particular version of Premiere. So you can use Window Spy to figure out exactly what that is, but keep in mind that that number can and will change if you change your workspaces inside of Premiere. Then it moves the cursor to an extremely precise pixel on the Effect Controls panel, where I know that the anti-aliasing on the very edge of this triangle is going to be a different color based upon whether it is untwirled or not. That is how I know if the Effect Controls are untwirled. So it goes through a couple of if statements and looks at colors to figure that all out. And if the color is just a normal panel color, it means that nothing has been loaded into the Effect Controls panel. And so it'll hit Control P, which is my shortcut for Selection Follows Playhead, in order to select the topmost targeted track at the playhead. And then it'll hit Control P again, because I prefer to leave that option off most of the time. And then it just goes back to the beginning of the function and does everything again now that the controls are probably available. And assuming that you have an untwirled effects controls panel, then it goes on to find VFX, which is another function inside of this function, again with one single parameter. And then it runs an image search for some very, very carefully taken PNG screenshots using foobar as the parameter, which is the name of that image, whether it be scale or rotation or anchor point or what have you. This is a kind of a derpy way to do it, but it works, so whatever. So assuming that it finds those little images, it will move the cursor straight on top of that text, and then it searches for a very particular color of blue, which is the color that the scrubbable hot text uses, which is located always to the right. You see, it searches all the way over, and when it finds blue, it'll stop, it'll put the cursor there, and it'll virtually press down the left mouse button for you. So right here, it checks to make sure that the VFX key is still being held down. If not, then it will reset the value of scale to 100 or rotation to 0. That's just a little bonus thing that I put in so that if you just tap the key, it'll reset that value rather than doing anything else. But assuming that you're still holding that key down, it enters this loop where you're given control back of the mouse cursor, and it will simply continue to hold down the left mouse button for you, and then you're free to move your mouse around in order to change the value of that hot text until you release the key. In which case, it will run one last function to reset everything back to the way that it was, and it puts your mouse cursor back where it came from. Now, there's one last thing that you might need in order to make this work, which is basically the hot text in Premiere is kind of broken, where it only starts to change if you really go quickly with your mouse, which is stupid. So there's another AutoHotKey script that you should have running all the time in case you have that bug, just to ensure that that bug is fixed. And once again, this is another thing that I wish was just a part of Premiere.